In part 2 of our lesson on angle relationships and similar triangles, we're going to review how to use the triangle sum theorem and how to classify triangles by their sides and angles. Back in your geometry class, you learned the triangle sum theorem, which states that the three angles of a triangle add to be 180 degrees. Now, let's take a look at why that happens. You can see here in this animation, if we cut out the angles in the triangle and line them up together, you can see that their exterior sides end up forming a line, and we know that a straight angle measures 180 degrees, so that's why the three angles of a triangle add to 180 degrees. So let's take a look at this example where we have to find the measure of angle C in triangle ABC. This will be a direct application of the triangle sum theorem. So we know that angle C plus 70 degrees plus 80 degrees will have to equal 180 degrees. Because the three angles of a triangle have to add to be 180. When we combine like terms, we get angle C plus 150 degrees is equal to 180. Subtract 150 from both sides, and we find out that angle C has to be 30 degrees. Okay, next let's review classifying triangles by their angles or sides. Now, when we're classifying triangles by their sides, there are three different types. The first is scalene, and when a triangle is scalene, that means no sides are equal to each other. Another way of looking at that is that all three sides are different. Now, in an isosceles triangle, we have two sides are equal. In an equilateral triangle, all three sides are equal. Now, classifying triangles according to their angles, we have four types. First is acute. An acute triangle means that all three angles are acute. A right triangle means that it has one right angle. And then, of course, the other two would have to be acute. A triangle can be obtuse, and that means it would have one obtuse angle. And again, the other two are acute. And now there's a fourth type, special type, and that's called equiangular triangle, and that means all three angles are equal. And if you think about that, the three angles of a triangle have to add up to be 180. So if all three of them have to be equal, then each of the angles has to be 60 degrees. So they will be 60 degrees. And a triangle that is equilateral is also equiangular. So if all three sides are equal, then we know that all three angles will also be equal. In this next example, we'll classify each triangle by its sides and angles. So that means we'll need two words to describe each triangle. Looking at this first one, we see that two of the sides are equal to each other, so we know that means it has to be isosceles. Next, we look at the angles. It does have a right angle in it, so we know we'll use the word right to describe the angles, and it is an isosceles right triangle. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. This next triangle, none of the sides are equal, so we know it will be scalene. And looking at the angles, while these two angles are acute, we can see that this angle here is obtuse. So we'll use the word obtuse to describe the angles, and this is a scalene obtuse triangle. Next, once again, none of the sides is equal to any other side, so that means it is a scalene triangle. All of the angles are acute, so we have a scalene acute triangle. This triangle here, all three sides are equal to each other, so we know that means it's going to be equilateral. And then when we learned our definitions, we discovered that equilateral triangles must also be equiangular. So equiangular is a special case of an acute triangle. We know all the angles are going to be 60 degrees, which means they're acute, but rather than call this an acute triangle, we call it the special case of equiangular. The next triangle, none of the sides is equal, so it is scalene. It has a right angle in it, so we call this a scalene right triangle. And finally, we see we have two sides are equal, so we know it is isosceles, and it has an obtuse angle in it, so this is an isosceles obtuse triangle.